Welcome back to Theme Park Wizard. This is part 2 of our Epic Universe update. This time we'll be looking at Super Nintendo World and specifically taking some close looks into Super Nintendo World. So I'm excited for that. But here is an overview of Super Nintendo World. The Mario Kart Show building is up on top with the center of the land and Mount Beanpole where the Red Tower Crane is. And yeah, let's take this close look into Mount Beanpole right now. We're zooming in into where the portal was about to be, but here is the steel and construction work for the Mountain Beanpole Princess Peach area. Here's, you can see the staircase is completed. And that staircase is leading all the way up to Bowser. Well, what will be Bowser's Castle? Toad's Cafe is that little curved area to the left. And there's the Yoshi. Mountain Beanpole's number 3, and Yoshi's People Movers where the number 5 is. Thank you again to Bio Reconstruct for the amazing footage. Here's an overview of the Yoshi People Mover attraction, or Yoshi's Adventure Ride. That white steel work to the top right is the Mount Beanpole construction, and the yellow track is what will be the Yoshi ride. And you can see the indoor segment where the pyramids will be is encased in steel to the left of the picture, as well as potential that building that juts out. That's the separation between Donkey Kong Country and Super Nintendo World, the main area. We'll go into Donkey Kong Country a little bit later. But yeah, the Mario Kart shopping is just about done, or it's definitely topped out, but it's almost fully enclosed as well. And Princess Peach's Castle, which is right by the Red Tower Crane, has its base fully formed as well, which is fantastic. Now we're going to take a moment to go outside of the land. So right, this white building you can see right here, not where the arrow is, but the white building that is full of walls and has no roof so far, that is the Super Nintendo World store. Yes, this will be a massive Nintendo themed store. This will be outside of the land in the hub, so you can access it whether you're inside Super Nintendo World or not. And I believe with the arrow, the yellow arrows, that might be the entrance portal. Yeah, the warp pipe entrance that will eventually be constructed into Super Nintendo World. And they'll be entering through Princess Peach's Castle, just like in the Japan version. And here's a close-up of the Mario Kart attraction. You can see the two arrows there are the first one that's pointing to something inside, but the red crane is pointing to the track. That's right. It's pointing to the nearly completed, probably definitely complete Mario Kart track. Next time you see this building, again, it might be enclosed, fully enclosed. It's almost enclosed right now, so this is what might be one of our last peeks at the Mario Kart track. And the outside is still frame work right now, but it will be encased in concrete and scaffolding later on. Here's a close look at all three attractions, a bit of all three attractions. The Mario Kart track is inside the building. Donkey Kong and the false track are right there on the bottom. And then to the yellow track and Mount Beanpole are over to the left-hand side. And we're going to do in a second a little split screen action and see a comparison of two different angles of the Donkey Kong coaster. It's super cool seeing this false track, and I can't wait till they install the spikes and everything. But you can see again, the real track is below, the false track is on top. So let's go take a look at this split screen here. So here's two different angles. So the right side is what we're just looking at, and the left side is a new angle. This is kind of a different vertical angle. We see most of the Mario Kart, the Donkey Kong track. You can see the real track and a lot of the false track being installed. You can see where the gaps are going to be. You can see where the real track changes colors to blend in with the themed environments that it's going to be built in. And let's go take a full look into this picture right now and kind of take a closer look inside. Alrighty, so yes, you can see the station and the main indoor show scene as to the right hand side, but we're going to take a close look at some of this false track here. As you can see, this will be zooming into the water feature area where we're going to be going into now. We'll be going through waterfalls and jumping over spikes. And you can see that the track is mostly, should actually could be complete, I believe. Because there, a lot of the false track is being installed right now. And it just looks fantastic. And lastly, let's take a close look at the whole overview of Super Nintendo World. Again, BioReconstruct killing it with these helicopter views of not just Universal, but Disney and all theme parks in Orlando as well. But yes, look at how massive. You can just, this is, shows you kind of the scale of how massive the Mario Kart attraction show building is. It is huge, and I like how it's, you can, from this angle, it looks like it's just connected with a whole still to the rest of the land, which it kind of is. But it just dwarfs the actual land of, like, the main Super Nintendo World proper, as you would call it. Donkey Kong Country is huge, too, but you can see how more open that area is. It's just, right now, it's a lot of dirt. There's really only one massive show building, or one show building, which is all the way to the left there in the back of the land. But Mario Kart really dwarfs everything. It's insane how massive and intricate this ride is, and really highly themed if you've seen the version in Japan. But what do you guys think of this Super Nintendo World? Are you excited for it? Are you going to skip? This is a good question. And let me know in the comments below, because I've been curious about this as well. Will you skip going to Hollywood's version and just wait for it? Orlando's version? No, Hollywood's version opens next year. Will you just, are you not going to make a trip to Hollywood's version and wait 2 more years to go to the full version in Orlando, or just fly to Japan? Very curious, especially if you're, depending on what part of the country you're in, you might just want to wait. I'd obviously want to go to both. I'll be in Hollywood's version next year since I'm right down the street. But if someone's in the middle of the country or the East Coast, they may not want to make the plane flight, and especially because they're getting the bigger, better version in just a couple of summers. So I'm very curious. Let me know about that in the comments below. Let me also know what you guys think of this Super Nintendo World progress. This looks fantastic. I mean, looks, you can see the shapes of things already being basically done. And the outline's there. The outline is right there. And they just got to install everything else. So it's coming along quite nicely here. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Make sure to subscribe to the channel for more theme park updates, Epic Universe updates, Super Nintendo World updates from Orlando and Hollywood, and Universe updates from both coasts as well. And like this video, press a thumbs up if you like this video, and have a fantastic day, everybody.